Now to a CBS 4 News security alert, and a new report warns about a big increase in data breaches affecting tens of millions of Americans. The Identity Theft Resource Center counted nearly 1,500 breaches of U.S. private and government organizations in 2019. CBS News correspondent Anna Werner reports.
I got a letter in the mail from Barclays Bank, and the letter said that my line of credit application was denied.
Jaspreet Singh says he hadn't filed for that line of credit or the parade of false loan applications that followed as crooks using his personal information tried over and over to run their scams in 2018 and 19, finally charging his business MasterCard for $4,500.
This $4,500 worth of charges were from somebody in Texas who were using my business credit card to run Facebook ads for their business.
Singh says his private information was exposed with millions of others in the 2017 Equifax hack, and odds are more people will face similar problems. In its 2019 end-of-year data breach report, the Identity Theft Resource Center says the number of data breaches went up 17%. The group says one significant new threat that emerged, consumers or companies' data being exposed through databases left unsecured. They say a number of large organizations simply failed to add a password to protect their cloud-based data. It's not known if that data was then stolen. Another trend that's exploded in the past year, they say, something called credential stuffing, where hackers buy someone's stolen login and password from the dark web, then see if that same combo gets them into other online accounts. The center's COO, James Lee.
The reason it's so easy is because so many of us use the same password for multiple accounts.
The report says noteworthy credential stuffing attacks in 2019 included Intuit, Boost Mobile, Dunkin', and the streaming service Disney Plus.
Singh says his credit card company did finally reimburse his card for the $4,500 in fraudulent charges. He also had to put a freeze on his credit with all three credit bureaus and flag the problem to all of his banks. Anna Werner, CBS News, New York.